Okay, good morning everyone. So yesterday we have completed nutrition part where we have checked about nutrition in animals, human beings. We have seen the role of various enzymes. What is meant by respiration? The second process that we are going to study. What do you do when you respire? You inhale and exhale. So when you inhale and exhale, that is simply a physical process. So will you call that a respiration process or breathing? And what is the difference between respiration and breathing? Yes. So simply inhaling and exhaling, that physical activity is basically breathing. But when you define it in more chemical terms, that is when you take food and then during the respiration, when that oxygen combines with the food and it releases energy in the form of ATP, we are going to study what is that. That is known as respiration, or you can say in simple sense oxidation of food. When you are saying it like oxidation of food, what do you mean to say? You mean to say that it is oxygen that is combining with the food material and releasing the energy. Obviously we have two types, aerobic and anaerobic, under respiration. You are studying standard 10 science, so obviously you know that all living things breathe. A question: why do we breathe? In order to stay alive, that would be a probable answer most of you would be giving. Yes, because we need oxygen. We need oxygen for performing lot of activities to stay alive also. This answer is not good enough as a 15-year-old. Let's think a bit more. Say you have this pile of wood with stored chemical energy and you want to generate energy out of it. So what would you do if you want to get energy from this fuel? From this firewood, then what we have to do? If you want to cook food, let's say, then if you want to generate energy, what you will have to do first? You have to heat it. Okay, you have to burn it. You would have to burn it to get energy. If you had water on it, then the water would heat up, generating steam, and the steam could do work. We have seen under sources of energy how steam was generating in a large amount and how it was rotating the blades of turbine, and then it was synchronized with the generator and all that thing. Okay. Now we need energy to stay alive and for our body to carry out different processes. So where will this energy come from? You have already eaten the food and digested it and you are breathing in oxygen. So once that oxygen combines with the food material, then and then only it will release energy. Yes, you know that you are breathing out carbon dioxide. So what must be going inside your body? Yes, you are eating the food material. You are also taking oxygen during the respiration process and you are breathing out carbon dioxide. So O2 combines with food, that gives us energy. The energy comes from burning the food. And to burn anything, obviously we require three things that you have studied in 8th standard, the triangle, fuel, heat, and all these things. And when we burn something with the help of oxygen, we create carbon dioxide, which we throw out because CO2 is a waste material. Right? Okay, so is this clear till this much? This was a preliminary information about respiration. Our body gets energy by burning the digested food. Now try to remember of the different things that we eat, the nutrients that we get from the food. It includes fats, carbohydrate, vitamins and minerals. So out of these, all the nutrients, what do you think? Where do we get energy from? Do we get it from fats? Do we get it from carbohydrates? Do we get it from vitamins or minerals? Yes, we get it from carbs. We get it from carbohydrates. Yeah, fat is also correct answer, but fat is generally stored in the form of glycogen in the adipose tissue of the human body. We can also extract energy from that. But if someone asks you what is an instant source of energy, then carbohydrates are the best option. Okay, vitamins and minerals are not energy providing, but they are important for various enzymatic activities that takes place inside your body. So let's fix that earlier statement. Our body gets energy by burning carbohydrates. And so respiration can also be thought as of a slow combustion. You know that combustion is another word of burning. It is slow combustion because you can't see the flame and the light that is produced. That is why the word slow. When we burn the pile of wood, it uses oxygen from the air and releases CO2 as it burns. And there is a pile of ash also that is left once the wood is all burned out. So do you think the same happens in the human body also? In our case, the food is present. That food is combining with oxygen. So is the case same? Like when you burn the wood, ash is left, some residue is left. So is it same in case of human beings also? Do we have some residue? Yes. What is that? Yes. So we have it in the form of CO2. The waste products that are generated during the burning are thrown out through the excretory system. Or even through the respiratory system, we exhale out CO2. That is a kind of waste material only. Where do you think this burning takes place? Burning of food materials and all. It takes place in lungs, alimentary canal or cell. It takes place in each and every cell of your body. Now let us study respiration. During the process of digestion, carbohydrates are converted into glucose, which is C6H12O6. You know the molecular formula of glucose. This glucose has to be broken down before it can be used, because unless and until it is broken down, energy cannot be released and you cannot use that. It is broken down into a carbon molecule called pyruvate, which is a 3-carbon atom. So this is an MCQ type and very, very important from 10th standard perspective perspective that glucose, that is C6 carbon atom containing compound, is broken down into a 3-carbon atom carrying compound that is nothing but pyruvate. Okay, glucose has 6 carbon atoms. So glucose is first broken down into pyruvate. Then in the presence of oxygen, if it is in the presence of oxygen, will that be aerobic or anaerobic respiration? That will be aerobic respiration. Okay? Yes. So what will be the product that will be released? So that is called as an aerobic respiration. And in aerobic respiration, what all is released? Carbon dioxide, water, and energy. So remember the end products also. Okay, glucose is broken down into pyruvate. Pyruvate is how many carbon atoms? It is 3 carbon atoms. And once that pyruvate is broken down in the presence of glucose, you get CO2, water, and energy. This is how energy is generated in our muscles. Sometimes when we are exercising too much, we may get cramps in our legs. So what happens there is that muscle needs a lot of energy. And your body is not providing the muscles enough energy. So what happens, why do you get cramps, is that you are exercising a lot, first of all. And for exercising, you need a lot of energy. And for energy demands, you need oxygen. But your body is not capable to generate that much oxygen. So therefore, we get cramps. So it tries to make energy without oxygen in that case. So glucose broken down into pyruvate. But if the condition is no oxygen, so in that case, what is produced? Lactic acid plus energy. Energy is released in that case also, but lactic acid is produced in the absence of O2. Okay, in muscle cells, when you are exercising a lot, when you are carrying out any physical activity a lot, that time. The lactic acid is what that gives us the cramps. Also, the energy generated is much lesser than the energy with O2. So the energy which is generated in the first case now with oxygen, in that case, the energy is very, very high, like 38 ATP molecules. But in this case, when there is no oxygen, the energy that is generated is very, very less. Did you know that there are some organisms on the earth that do not use oxygen at all for respiration? Can you name those organisms? Yeast is one such example. It's not like yeast tries to respire without oxygen in tough times. Yeast just does not use oxygen at all, like for respiration purpose. So how does respiration take place in case of yeast? So ethanol is a kind of alcohol and is the main ingredient in beer, wine, brandy, etc. So pyruvate, once it is formed, in the absence of oxygen, it is broken down into ethanol plus CO2 plus energy. This takes place in case of yeast cells. Okay. So ethanol is how many carbon atoms? Yes, number of carbon atoms present in ethanol. Yes, 2. What is the functional group of ethanol? Yes, alcohol. OH is that the functional group. Functional group means those are basically group of atoms or heteroatoms which when get attached to your hydrocarbon, it entirely changes the property of that particular hydrocarbon compound. Okay. Is this clear what all happens with oxygen, with no oxygen and all? So you can see if it is aerobic under muscle, remember the end products. This chart is very, very important from MCQ point of perspective. Okay, so this is the data. What you can take from this data for MCQ is how much energy conversion takes place in aerobic and anaerobic. The rest you all know. This is the factual data that you need to remember, that one glucose, when it is broken down, it releases 38 ATP molecule. ATP is nothing but energy packets. Okay, energy is produced in your body in the form of some energy packets, which is nothing but ATP. Whereas in anaerobic respiration, one glucose molecule, when it is broken down into pyruvate and things like that, so it releases only 2 ATP molecules. So therefore, we were saying that in aerobic, the amount of energy produced is far more in number as compared to anaerobic respiration. Okay, you could also say, you can also get a question like this, that out of the following, which one of the following is known as energy currency of the cell? So energy currency is nothing but ATP only. Okay. The breakdown of glucose to pyruvate happens in the cytoplasm of the cell. Again, an MCQ part, that when this breakdown is taking place, that is glucose to pyruvate, can you specify the location? So they will give you 4 locations, maybe cytoplasm, mitochondria, and then you have to choose the perfect location. So remember, it takes place in the cytoplasm of the cell. The breakdown of pyruvate happens in the mitochondria, which is also known as powerhouse of the cell. Okay, so let us go through the textbook. I'll just show you that flowchart. Even if you just study this figure 6.8, most of the part of respiration that we have covered today, you will be able to understand that. So you can see glucose, a 6-carbon molecule. The breakdown is taking place in cytoplasm. So cytoplasm is that site. It is broken down into pyruvate, that is a 3-carbon molecule. If the pyruvate has to be broken down further into CO2, water and energy in the presence of oxygen, what is the site? It is mitochondria. Remember the sites, very, very important from MCQ point. Then lack of oxygen, where is the site? In muscle cells, when we are exercising a lot. Absence of oxygen, it takes place in yeast. So each and every word given under figure 6.8 is very, very important. Breakdown of glucose by various pathways, or what they can do, they can design this flowchart and they will just write A plus B. So you have to identify what is A and you have to identify what is B. Okay, so these are all the probability how the questions can be designed. Is it clear? Okay, so let us now study about what ATP means. We have been using these terms very frequently in today's lecture. So ATP is nothing but the energy currency for most cellular process. Cellular process means the process that takes place at cellular level, at cell level. The energy released during the process of respiration is used to make an ATP molecule from ADP and inorganic phosphate. I'll just tell you this. So ATP stands for adenosine triphosphate. Okay, this is the full form of ATP. Then ADP is adenosine diphosphate. This is the full form of ADP. Okay. What is the meaning of triphosphate? 3 phosphorus groups are attached. That is why triphosphate. In ADP, only 2 are there. Therefore, it is di. Di means 2. 2 phosphate linkage. Okay, you don't have the structure of it because it is a very huge structure. You get it in 12th under biology, somewhat that kind of stuff. So for 10th, just remember these information which I have told to you, the full forms. And triphosphate means three phosphate linkage. And phosphate group, you know, no? PO43 minus. This was there in your 9th standard. PO43 minus under atoms and molecule chapter. So this is phosphate. And adenosine diphosphate contains two phosphate linkage. Okay. So what happens is ADP that is present in the body, it combines with one molecule of inorganic phosphate. So now what it will give? Earlier there were two phosphate linkages, and now you have added one more phosphate linkage. So what will it now produce? What will be the product? Yes, you will get ATP. Okay. Inorganic phosphate means this phosphate, the phosphate which is inorganic in nature, that doesn't contain carbon, hydrogen, inorganic compounds. So you can see over here ADP plus inorganic phosphate. This requires energy. The combination of all or these two things require energy. Then there is a linkage that is established between ADP. You can see a small linkage and inorganic phosphate. And finally, it results into ATP molecule. Endothermic process in the cells then use this ATP to drive the reaction. So if any cell wants to use energy, they can break down this ATP and they can utilize the energy produced. When terminal phosphate linkage in ATP is broken using water, the energy is equivalent to 30.5 kilojoule per mole. Again, an MCQ kind of information. See, in ATP, you have three phosphate linkage, right? And when the third linkage, that is the terminal phosphate linkage, is broken down using water, the energy that is produced is how much? 30.5 kilojoule per mole. Means 1 mole se aapko 30.5 kilojoule ki energy milti hai. That means if you have 1 mole of ATP and you are breaking down the terminal phosphate linkage, terminal means end wala phosphate linkage, then the energy that is produced is 30.5 kilojoule per mole. Think of how a battery can provide energy for many different kind of uses. It can be used to obtain mechanical energy, light energy, electrical energy, and so on. Okay. Similarly, ATP can be used in the cell for contraction of muscles, because for that purpose also you require energy. Protein synthesis, everything that is going inside your body at cellular level requires some energy, and that is made by ATP. Okay. Understood? So this is what we have just seen in the textbook. When the last phosphate bond in ATP is broken, it releases a lot of energy, and that is why it is called as energy currency of the cell. Okay, so this is ADP plus inorganic phosphate. I told you that the combination of ADP and inorganic phosphate requires water and energy. So when they get these conditions, it forms ATP. Now when you break down this ATP, what do you get back? Yes, if you break down the ATP, it again releases energy and it again gives you ADP plus inorganic phosphate. So this cycle keeps on going on. Okay, so this is a kind of a battery where you don't have any energy and then you get energy, so it is totally green in color. Right? Then we are going to move to the next PPT, or next part of the PPT rather, oxygen intake in organisms. Let us talk about plants. Plants, you know, through stomata, their gaseous exchange process takes place. And in stomata, what do we have? We have guard cells that encloses the stomatal pore. How is the entry, entry and exit of gases regulated by guard cells? It is regulated by water. Diffusion of O2 and CO2 through large intercellular spaces. Respiration releases CO2. We know that in plants, CO2, when it is released, it is respiration. It takes place via stomata, which are the small pores present on the surface of leaves. Okay. During the daytime, what happens is CO2 is taken again for the photosynthesis, because you require CO2 as a raw material. CO2 plus water in the presence of chlorophyll forms C6H12O6, that is glucose. And then O2 is given out during photosynthesis. Okay. This oxygen, which is released during the process of photosynthesis, comes from CO2 or water. The oxygen that is released during the process of photosynthesis is coming out from CO2 or water. It is coming out from water, splitting of water. Okay, the second step of photosynthesis. So at night there is no photosynthesis, there is no sunlight, that is why so CO2 is given out, right? Let us see what happens in case of animals on land. They breathe in oxygen through air. Atmosphere has oxygen, right? There are large surface area of organs to come in contact with O2. So if you think of us, because we are also animals and we are also living on land, which organ do we use for respiring? Yes, we use lungs. What is present inside lungs? Where the exchange of gases takes place. Though we are going to learn it in tomorrow's class, but if you have the information, very good. Alveoli. These are the sac-like structures, balloon-like structures, which are present inside the lungs. And those are the sites where actually the gaseous exchange takes place. Okay, so they provide large surface area of organ to come in contact with oxygen. Fine and delicate surface needed for diffusion. This is very important. If the surface area is large, now then and then only the respiration process can be happening in an efficient manner. Delicate organs need protection. So if it is a heart, if it is a lung, they need to be protected, right? So in our body, who protects them? The branching are bronchi, and when they end up into a balloon or sac-like structures, which are called as alveoli. So in our body, like heart and lungs and all these are delicate organs, right? So what is there inside our body to protect these delicate organs? Bones, or to be more precise, ribs, rib cage. So therefore, inside the body of the organism, mechanism to move. This is about a flowchart, how do respiration takes place in land animals. Then animals who are residing in water, like fishes, pisces, that class, they use oxygen dissolved in water. What is the thing which is present in the pisces for respiration organ? Yes, they have gills. So quantity of dissolved oxygen is less. In this case, whatever oxygen is present in the water, it is present in a very less amount. The reason being is nowadays we are also polluting a lot of water. So the oxygen quantity has become very less. And that is the reason why organism living in water, their respiration rate is far more in quantity as compared to the animals who are living on land. So organism has to breathe more to compensate. Therefore, breathing is at much faster rate. So this was also an assertion reason type question that was framed last year. I'll just show you that statement in the textbook. Yes, this is that statement which I was talking about. So these two statements were printed under assertion and reason type. Since the amount of dissolved oxygen is fairly low compared to the amount of oxygen in air. See, oxygen that is present in air is around 21%, and the oxygen that is present in water is very, very less in number. Therefore, the rate of breathing in aquatic animals or aquatic organism is much faster than that seen in the terrestrial organism. So this was the assertion reason type. Assertion was given like this, that animals or aquatic organisms have faster breathing rate. And under reason, they have printed this statement that since the amount of dissolved oxygen is fairly low compared to amount of oxygen in air, therefore rate is higher. So what would be the case in this assertion and reason type? What will be your answer? Yes, it will be A. Assertion and reason both are true, and reason is actually the correct explanation of assertion. Yes. Okay. So please take care of this. Again, assertion reason type question. Terrestrial organism use the oxygen in the atmosphere for respiration. This oxygen is absorbed by different organisms in different organs in different animals. We have seen how they need very fine and delicate surfaces. They need protection because these are delicate organs. Okay, so this was all about what we have covered today. About human respiration in detail, we will be covering in tomorrow's class.
If you like our videos, do share them and subscribe to our channel. If you want awesome quizzes, write to us. Keep watching and keep learning with Walnut.